Center weather alert.
Another busy day west Michigan with plenty of snow, wind, and of course, the Arctic air continuing to be here. So take a live look outside the ballpark. Definitely no baseball today, but plenty of snowfall, and we are seeing more additional snow today from what we already had yesterday. This is some of the look back at some of our snowfall totals from yesterday. Coopersville and Sparta coming out on top, over 12 inches of snow. So this has really been that light, fluffy snow consistency, and that's what's allowed it to stack up so quickly and give us these high snow totals like this. And we actually broke some records for single day snowfall. So we've seen our fair share of snow already tomorrow, and this continues again today. Still focused in on the heart of West Michigan, but with this light, fluffy snow, the further you get away from Grand Rapids, this can fall below the radar. The radar beam continues to get higher and higher as you move away from Grand Rapids. So even though it's not showing it here, it can still be snowing in Fremont and Howard City and Big Rapids, and similarly as we travel south of I-96. You can even see around I-94 and southward as you travel to the state line, the snow fills in as well, and even all across the Great Lakes. It will continue through the rest of the day today and even tomorrow before high pressure starts to slowly move in and slowly shut it down. I'll show you in a moment on future track. These temperatures, though, they're no joke yet again today as we are in the 20s and teens. Our warmth along the lakeshore, not only with our actual temperatures, but our feel like temperatures as well, because these winds today make us feel colder, but they're not as gusty as what we were yesterday. Yesterday we had some wind gusts peaking at 45, 50 miles per hour. Today I think we could see still 20 to 25 mile per hour wind gusts, but nothing like the strength we had yesterday. Still makes us feel colder though, in the teens and single digits, even negatives for Battle Creek and Coldwater, but that warmth along the lakeshore due to that assistance from Lake Michigan. And this trend, it continues into the evening, feeling like the single digits in the teens and even throughout the day tomorrow. So for the rest of your Thursday, we'll keep those temperatures in the 20s, feeling colder, the snow, the wind, the cloud cover. We have it all over again, and it continues even into this evening with more of that lake effect snow set up. But check out those temperatures, 4 degrees. That's all we get. That's what we'll drop back to overnight. But just remember, the next couple of days, today and tomorrow, we have a little bit of a warm up on the way for the weekend. The 30s. We'll consider that a warm up, especially with how cold it has been the last several days. So here's a look as we are still under a winter storm warning for everyone, mostly along the lakeshore in the pink coloring here and the purple as you travel inland, that winter weather advisory all until 10 a.m. tomorrow. So this is what we can get additionally for our snowfall on top of what we have already gotten. So the dark blue there, mostly south and west of Grand Rapids, an additional 6 to 10. Maybe some of you could pump out another 12, 13 inches of snowfall. And then as you travel more inland and more north and east, that snowfall total continues to decrease. So it's that lakeshore west of 131. You'll see the most of this snowfall. And this is what it looks like on future track, just continues to push that lake effect band through the afternoon, evening, and even into the day tomorrow. But it's this high pressure that will slowly build in, slowly shut this off as we go throughout the day on Friday and give us a little bit of a break for the weekend. We start to get in the warm sector of this system, so that's our warm up with the 30s, and we could see a random sprinkle or a random flurry, but nothing like what we've had yesterday or today. So there's the start of your 7-day forecast. 21 degrees tomorrow, 33 on Saturday, so there you go, a little improvement for you. 35 on Sunday. But Sunday can actually be a little bit of a fooler, because this 35 degrees on Sunday actually going to happen early. Our temperatures drop and plummet throughout the day as we get another push of Arctic air as we're back in the teens. 15 degrees on Monday with lake effect snow showers again. 19 on Tuesday. Finally next Wednesday, rebounding back into the